Or both would be in the middle.
Strangers come up to me and ask, what are you doing when you're making the next record? And I always sort of give them vague answers, and you're kind of always making a record anyway, because your life and every day, it's all gonna end up in there somehow, disguised. So it's a sort of constant process. It's not an easy thing to make an album. I mean, it's better than digging a ditch, but it's not the easiest job. I always forget, and I come back and think, you know, this is so easy. I suppose it is like a mission. You have certain rules and limitations and a certain terrain that you can operate within, and it still classes music, and so you're limited. So it is a bit like being a soldier, because you somehow have to find in yourself the ability to choose what you think at that time is the best thing.
Sounds lovely.
She's never ever seemed to have doubted what it was she wanted. You feel like you are on this
whole thing, just
this sort of quest that's always been at the back of her mind. She's got more stamina than the rest of us.
There are always times when we're making albums that it's just brilliant.
You know, you've been working on a song for a while, slaving at it, and then you suddenly play it back, you know, with other people in the room, and it just sounds incredible.
No, it's fun, you know. Yeah, we love each other.
Because we all live in different continents, we tend to get together at a certain place. There are no songs actually written before we get in the studio, which is why it takes us a long time.
The thing is, though, it took me an hour to play one note. Do you know what I mean? Have we got that hour?
Once I start working on a song, I sort of feel I'm on a boat and the boat knows which way it's going. Sometimes the boat will go off course and I have to fight to steer it back.
How many words? Look, all of this. Just one song. Oh, it's what's chipped away.
She likes to divorce herself from the daily world, from the outside world, in order to kind of be off somewhere in this special place, you know, where she creates something.
Sade can just be sitting at a table, looking out of the window, and, you know, it's really windy. I'm sort of pissed off because I can't go on my bike because it's too windy and rainy, and she's actually loving it, looking out the window, seeing all the trees blowing, and that'll completely inspire her, you know, to write something like Safest Hiding Place or Morning Bird.
Thank you.
the 3 minutes where the song really comes together in that moment where it sort of arrives from the ether or wherever. Then the rest, a lot of the rest is working on maintaining that the spirit that came to you from no will of your own. Now that's the difficult part, being loyal to the original vibration and spirit of feeling that came with that song.
Where that comes from, I don't know. It just happens. Other times it's like an awful, dreadful birth, you know, trying to push the thing out. But other times it's just so easy. It's just you can't force it. You can't say, oh, today is going to be the day we're going to do something great.
I think she likes it when she's not entirely in control. When she likes it when she just kind of like, you know, is a bit unconscious, not thinking too much, not too thought out. She likes the happy accidents.
There can be long periods of sort of what feel like kind of constantly honing away at something, but at the same time, the result is always it just seems right. The small step I need to take is a mountain stretched out like a lazy dog. Send me to
just go in the studio. Okay, we're gonna go in the studio and do an album in like a week. I mean, I can't. You know, it's just the way we work at this point. I can't see that happening.
What would I say?
Trumpet
bits.
You
don't have to write it out. It's so simple at the beginning. You know what it kind of wants to do.
It's as good as we can do right now, which is all that matters.
I don't think an album's ever what you want it to be. But I wouldn't let it go if I didn't feel it was as good as we can get right now. I didn't ever want to be a singer. I ended up being a singer. I mean, I've developed skills, I suppose, over the years. I'm more capable than I used to be. I'm more able to express what I want to. I'm less limited, but I never had the sort of, I suppose, a lot the aspirations that a lot of singers have, and that's probably why I'm quite, in some ways, I'm uncomfortable with the fame. My heart's been lonely warriors been too long. I'm happy to try my hardest to do great works, and then, you know, it's a bit like a message in the bottle. I prefer to would just prefer to chuck it in the sea and see where it shows up. It's all quite introvert, you know, you're in the studio, it's all about feelings, it's all internal, and then suddenly, bang, you have to go out there into the world and represent yourself. And I'm probably better at doing that musically than in any other way.
All I know is, we all four of us, we all have different roles. You take one person, one of us out, it doesn't work anymore.
I think if any of us were like 10% better, it would become muso-y, and it would become everything that we hate.
Yeah, we've got older and wiser, but there is that sense that we haven't wanted to sort of sit there as sort of, you know, nice sort of wise people who just sit there and, you know, make beautiful music. You know, it is, we struggle at it, and it's great that we still do that, that we haven't tired of that struggle.
I never feel that feeling of people needing me, because if I was to feel that, then I don't think I could cope with those feelings that of responsibility. Having said that, though, I do feel a responsibility when we're making the music to create something with love in it, so I think people can then feel it, and that's what you're giving them. I'm never flippant about music, you know, what we do. It's always like a mission and a task which I don't undertake lightly. My heart has been a lonely warrior before. It's been too long.